please get ready for a dictation of part 2 of transcription number 128, beginning from words 528 onwards, from Sir Kailash Chandra magazine. 5 seconds. Start. There may be coordination of this institute with the 4 others that we want to establish, but there should be affiliation with no other university. My 3rd point is that the Education Ministry must make a census of how many students are going for technological and engineering degrees in foreign universities, and why those students, after their fundamental research, after acquiring their PhD degrees from those universities, after acquiring distinction in their training, are not returning to this country to serve our industries where we so much require them. If the Education Ministry goes into this fact, they will find that there are about 300 students both in America and in Europe working in the factories after getting their PhD degrees, after acquiring the highest qualification in composition with other foreign students. Can we not get them into our country? They will serve our cause much better than there. Why are they denied this opportunity? Because we have no openings here. We should make efforts to bring them here. They have been working for 10 or 15 years in some factories in foreign countries, and we are permitting our factories and the public sector to draw upon IAS officers for management. IAS officers are good for working in administrative jobs, but for working in the factories, they are of no use. Therefore, import those 300 or 400 students who are residing in those foreign countries, who are working in those factories after acquiring their degrees in competition with foreign students by even giving them their terms if necessary. I think the terms offered to the Indian Administrative Service or the Indian Police Service should be different from what should be offered to technical personnel. It should be so because if a man is properly trained, he can reduce the cost in the factory by 10%. A reduction of 10% in the cost of production will go a long way. If, for example, the original cost is about 1 crore of rupees, then this would mean a saving of 10 lakhs of rupees. This is done purely by their technical genius, and this genius has gone out of the country. This should be brought back and they should be taken on their own terms if necessary. First of all, those engineers and other technicians who are working in foreign countries should be persuaded to come here. We are working under a system wherein we get only the IAS officers and not others. We should ask our ambassadors to make a list of such persons. They will be satisfied to work in India on a much lower salary. Even if you get a very highly qualified man from our factories, the Union Public Service Commission does not endorse his application. Stop.